Hello everybody, my name is Peter Koutnyy, and today I will speak about game Aryan Tari Andrey Esipenko. Why? I will speak about this game from Tata Steel Master 2021 round number 11, because both players are a really young chess player. Aryan Tari is, I think, 22 years old boy, and Andrey Esipenko is still 18 years old boy. So both players are young chess stars. They are players of new chess generation. So great future is waiting for them, and let's watch the game where these young chess players were playing to each other. Okay, one day Andrey Esipenko is beating Magnus Carlsen, another day he is losing to Aryan Tari. That's life, and that's the reason why it's good to watch this game. What's happened between these two young chess players? Okay, normal position, but I will tell you that black will be too passive, and that's the lesson to us. Don't be passive, don't play passive moves, and if you are searching for victories, for famous victories, just search for activity, and that's the biggest message from this game. And I will tell you that Andrey Esipenko will be really, really passive. So white took on e5, and now watch these two bishops. The difference between these two bishops there is that black's dark square's bishop is blocked by e5 pawn, and white's light square's bishop is blocked by e4 pawn. Bad bishops. Knight to f4 looks like black is searching for activity. Yes, it's a golden chess rule speaking that if our opponent has a piece in our territory, and in this case we are speaking about this knight on f4, it's a really important plan to challenge this bishop somehow. It's not a good idea now to take this knight by a bishop, because then black will enjoy two bishops advantage, but it's still important to challenge this knight. How white will challenge this knight? He will play knight to e3 and knight to d5, and he will do the same thing to black. He will place his knight to opponent's territory. That's interesting time of this game, where white is challenging this knight by placing our knight to opponent's territory. So knight to e3 and knight to d5, as I told you, that's the plan how to attack a knight in our territory. Okay, I don't believe that the right move is to play knight to e6. Watch black's bishops. Both black's bishops are passive bishops, and that's not everything. Soon black will be out of moves because of his huge passivity. Move h4 is an interesting move, because maybe black will play move h5, and this move will happen here. Okay, looks like not a bad move, but if black will play move f5, g6, h7, g8 and f7, all these light squares around black's king will be weak squares, and everything happened because of move h5. So yes, just now looks like this move stopped white to play move h5, but maybe in future there will be lots of weak light squares around black's king. Okay, bishop to e3, nothing happened till now. B4, I like this move a lot. You know, b4 move is taking space. It's taking space, maybe now is taking a5 and a c5 squares. So now let's speak about black's pieces. Knight on c6 is a bad knight. Knight on e6 is another bad knight, because it's very difficult job to find for them good squares. Bishop on d7 is another bad piece, and the same story is speaking about this bishop. So this bishop is another bad piece, and all three black's heavy pieces are still bad. So let's speak here about huge black's passivity. You know, where is passivity? There is problems. And absolutely here, blacks got problems because it's hard to find counterplay for them. Knight to e7. Okay, he's going to challenge this knight. And white is waiting what black will do. Knight to c8, and you know, that's another strange move. Knight is going to c8. Why this knight is going to c8? Just watch this knight on c8. It's for first look a really weak move. Okay, c4 and c5. So knight on c8 lost another two squares. Yes, now it's really impossible to go to d6 and to b6. And just to go to e7, it's not a big victory. So black's pieces remain too passive still, and just white's enjoying nice advantage because if his opponent has not attacked, so white is okay, and just white will improve his pieces by move h3. Okay, now just to do something with this piece. Okay, looks like, as I told you, on e4, this piece has problems. Just play to b3 and c4, and you will see that step by step, move by move, white is improving his pieces. That's a great chess plan. You know, one of the most important chess plan in the middle game is to play with all our pieces, and it's necessary to play and to improve our pieces. Main plan, good plan, and you know, Aryan Tari is playing simple chess. He played bishop to b3 and bishop to c4. Okay, black took and he exchanged rooks. f5 seems to me like to be a big mistake. It's difficult to believe that in huge passivity will f5 move work. Of course, no, because white will take and watch. As I told you, weaknesses around black's king. You know, too many weaknesses are here, and still, black pieces are bad. They are bad, they are passive, and no, knight to g5. And this pawn is now weak pawn. So that means this queen need to remain somewhere there to support this pawn or to defend this pawn. Okay, f4, and now look this diagonal. h7, g6, f7, g8. That's all weak black squares. Now is waiting for a black a really nice shot. Is waiting rook to a8, and that's a nice illustration how black is passive, because you know it's really hard to take this piece because of checkmate. Check, and here's a checkmate. And as I told you, all weak light squares are losing squares for black. Okay, we are nearly at the end, so well done to Aryan Tari because he played a really simple chess. And he was beating Andrey Esipenko. So even Andrey Esipenko beat Magnus Carlsen. Just today, he was a weaker chess player and he lost against Aryan Tari. And well done to Aryan Tari. Knight to a3, bishop to d3. That's game over because black took here and he resigned. Okay, what to play here? For example, of course, because of threat checkmate on h7, maybe black is going to f6. No way, it's a check. If it's going to g7, it's losing immediately because of move bishop to c3. Yes, I hope you see that black will lose on e5 pawn. And if it's going to g8, it's losing pawn immediately. One on e5, f4, c7. So I hope that you understand that you understand why Andrey Osipenko resigned here. So what to say? Well done to Aryan Tari. He played a really good chess. And Andrey Esipenko, I think he was too passive. It was hard to find a good piece. Just I don't remember any part of his activity, counterplay and attack. And this was not the best game of Andrey Esipenko, maybe the worst game from his tournament in Wigansee. Okay, I hope you agree. So at the end of this video, I'd like to thank you for watching. I'd like to thank you for every likes and of course follows. I like new followers and just to be one big chess family, just to see another hope interesting chess video next time. And I'm going to thank you for your time, for your watching and for your attention. So one more time, thank you. And I hope I will see you soon in our another YouTube chess video. Thank you and see you soon. Bye bye.